Today, I want to talk about my journey to software development. And it starts when I'm a 12-year-old boy sitting in my bedroom at home, having received a Commodore PET, which is an ancient 8-bit computer that my uncle brought to me, and I wanna program the world. Now, at that time, I didn't really know what programming was. And I had no formal education. I'm just 12 years old. So there's no languages like C and Pascal, and this is before all of that. But what I wanted to do, and the magic that I saw in the computer, was that you could play a game. At that time, it was Pong. That was pretty much the only game that existed. Two little bats going up and down and a ball bouncing between them. And that was just fascinating. And I thought, I want to be able to draw a game like that. Well, it turns out you need to be able to do some graphics. And graphics, as it turns out, is nothing more than turning on little lights on the screen, pixels, right? Picture elements. And so the very first program I ever wrote as a 12-year-old boy sitting in my room on my Commodore PET was the ability to turn on a single pixel on the screen. And then that turned into, oh, I can draw rectangles and I can draw squares and, you know, hey, mom, come look, a little square. Wow, yeah, that's very nice. But this is what really excited me. It was just being able to control a machine and say, I want this to be displayed, and it would just do it. So the demos I'm going to give here are my journey from setting single pixels to doing way more complex things and showing the process of composition that makes it possible to do very complex programs without writing super hard code. Because I do believe that pretty much anyone can code. The hardest part of it is being able to structure your thinking in such a way that you compose elements rather than creating super complexity, right? So the first demo, I'm just gonna do set pixel. And this is my daughter's favorite program. She wants to see some unicorns and stars and dancing kids and stuff, but she wants a rainbow. And I coded it up, and it's nothing more than setting individual pixel elements on the screen to be a certain color. Now, they're done in such a way that they follow a curve, so there's a little bit of math in there. There's a function called a Bezier function. You give it 4 points, it draws a curve between those points. That's it. Other than that, all I have to do is say, set a pixel, set a pixel, set a pixel, set a pixel, and I decide the color. And then I've got my rainbow and the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. That application's pretty good. There's no interacting with it. It just displays the picture and that's it. There are no dancing children. There's no unicorns flying. There's no audio. But this would have excited me as a 12-year-old boy sitting in my bedroom programming on my Commodore PET. Just a simple ability to draw something graphic on the screen. But that's great. But programs are much more interesting than that. There's interaction. It's not just set a static picture and call it a day. You need to click on stuff, move stuff around, type things in. So the second program goes into a little bit more complexity. Yes, they're setting pixels. It's getting more complex. It's not just an arc. There's rectangles. Well, what's a rectangle, really? A rectangle is just a single line duplicated many times. Well, what's a single line? Well, a single line is nothing but a bunch of set pixels duplicated. So duplicate pixels across, you get a line. Duplicate lines down, you get a rectangle. So a keyboard is nothing more than a bunch of rectangles gathered together and duplicated down. So now I've got a picture of a keyboard. Well, this is useful when I have a tablet or I have a phone, and it's interactive. So I can type on it, and you can see that the keys are being highlighted. You can tell all the keys that are being touched at any given time, which gives you actually some very complex interactions that you could do if you felt like it. This is very useful, and it's again done through composition. It doesn't make super hard calls. It doesn't have super complex data structures. The algorithms are very simple. The third program takes set pixel to its full glory. Here I have a 3D model that is composed, again, graphically out of nothing more than set pixel. In this case, I'm actually drawing triangles. And those triangles, just like rectangles, are just lines. But these lines have color. Unlike the rectangles, which were just a single color, these colors are coming from a picture of Diablo. And it says that color goes here, this color goes here, and you get a complex image like this. But again, at a graphics level, it's just single set pixels. At a bigger level, I need to compose it. I need a camera, I need a floor, I need a distance, I need a view that I can rotate around. So the complexity comes by composing some more complex math. Again, this is not PhD level mathematics or even computer science. The concepts are still simple. I set a pixel, but now I have to think about the algorithms. These algorithms are pretty much off the shelf. You just take a matrix, you take a vector, you take a camera, you take a view, you put it together in a very well-known structured way, and you get a 3D view of an object. This is composition of programming. This is the way I like to do stuff. It's simple, it's memorable, it's teachable, does not require a PhD in computer science. Anyone can do this.